published 1730 est, the 5th of December 2017 updated 2016 est, the 5th of December 2017 Russia's team have been banned from the Winter Olympic Games in February because of systemic manipulation of the anti-doping system. But the International Olympic Committee have stopped short of banning their athletes altogether, allowing clean individuals to compete in Pyeongchang under strict conditions as an Olympic athlete from Russia with the acronym OAR. They will compete under the Olympic flag with the Olympic anthem played at any medal ceremony. Vitaly Mutko, president of the Russian Football Union, has been given a lifetime Olympic ban. Mutko's ban is humiliating for FIFA after he took part in last week's World Cup draw in Moscow. It is a move that once again leaves the IOC open to accusations of weak leadership, given that the organization's president, Thomas Bach, described Russian doping, in particular at the last Winter Games in Sochi, as an unprecedented attack on integrity of Olympic Games and sport. But Bach insisted at a press conference in Lausanne on Tuesday that they had a duty to protect the rights of clean athletes. After the conclusion of a 17-month investigation led by former president of Switzerland, Samuel Schmid, some sanctions were perhaps more significant. A ban from all future Olympic Games for former sports minister and current Russian Deputy Prime Minister Vitaly Mutko is hugely embarrassing for FIFA ahead of next summer's World Cup. Mutko remains the president of Russian football, and only last week he shared the stage with FIFA president Gianni Infantino as the head of the World Cup organizing committee. FIFA said the sanctions had no impact on the preparations for the World Cup and would not comment on the action against Mutko. In 2015, an independent, WADA-commissioned report into Russian doping said there was evidence that pointed to doping in the Russian game. This has since been supported by evidence presented by former Russian anti-doping chief-turned-whistleblower Dr. Grigory Rodchenkov. Mutko is currently Russia's deputy prime minister and the country's former sports minister. On Tuesday, the International Olympic Committee banned Russia from competing at the upcoming Winter Games in Pyeongchang after examining evidence of state-sponsored doping. However, this week Schmid said many allegations that were made by Rodchenkov and with regard to Russian football we could not verify. That doesn't mean they are erroneous, added Schmid. But we were unable to prove they were correct. Bach was asked if he would attend the World Cup final in Moscow next July as a guest of FIFA. I don't have an invitation, but when the invitation comes I will decide, he said. Russia continued to deny that there was a state-sponsored doping program, and a decision is expected on Wednesday on whether President Vladimir Putin will call for Russia to boycott the games. On Tuesday night, Russian state television company VGTRK said it would not be broadcasting events in Pyeongchang. Schmid, in summarizing his report, said the findings were based only on material evidence, on documents and proof as well as testimonies and correspondence. The ban is set to cause a major impact on next year's competition in Pyeongchang, South Korea, particularly in figure skating, cross-country skiing, speed skating and bobsleigh have never seen such manipulation and cheating, and this has caused unprecedented damage to sport, he said. A statement from the IOC listed the sanctions, primarily to suspend the Russian Olympic Committee ROC with immediate effect. It also said the IOC would not accredit any official from the Russian Ministry of Sport for the Olympic Winter Games Pyeongchang 2018. And it would exclude the then Minister of Sport, Mr. Vitaly Mutko, and his then-deputy minister, Mr. Yuri Nagornik, from any participation in all future Olympic Games. Dmitry Chernyshenko, the former CEO of the organizing committee Sochi 2014, has been withdrawn from the Coordination Commission for Beijing 2022, while ROC President Alexander Zhukov has been suspended as an IOC member. Russians who are considered clean may still participate as Olympic athletes from Russia. The IOC also fined the ROC £11.16 million to reimburse the costs of the various investigations into Russia's cheating and to help set up the IOC's new independent testing authority. It may partially or fully lift the suspension of the rock from the commencement of the closing ceremony of the Olympic Winter Games Pyeongchang 2018, provided these decisions are fully respected and implemented by the rock and by the invited athletes and officials. The participation of individual Russian athletes will be determined by a panel chaired by Valery Fournarin, chair of the ITA. Athletes must be considered clean to the satisfaction of this panel, said the statement.